I like designing for children. They're very free. Children have strong tastes in their clothes. They like to wear certain clothes. But once they put them on, they forget them. They don't take great care of their clothes. They're not conscious that I mustn't kneel down, I'll spoil this, or I'm not wearing the right clothes to make mud pies. They'll do whatever they feel like doing at the time. They're just completely absorbed in what they're doing. They've forgotten what they're wearing.
Butterfly coming on, Diane. What kind is it, do you know? It's a made-up one, isn't it?
I think children like an attractive uniform. They like to feel they belong to a school. And it helps to give them pride in the school, too. I think, too, that the same applies to school clothes as applies to the school. It shouldn't be like the doctor's medicine used to be, brown and horrid, or else it wasn't doing you any good. Why be as dull as ditch water? Unless you give the children something they're happy in, you're making your school have the wrong flavour.
Children have very firm ideas about colour. Given the choice, they will select bright colours. They instinctively go for yellow and red. They will then go for shades of blue and then green. But yellow and red are always the first colours they pick, because they associate bright colours with happiness. They feel happy picking them and selecting them. And they paint that way as well. If they want to show that the mother or the situation or whatever it is miserable, they'll paint it in dark colours. There's a very strong association that bright colours means happy things and dark colours mean sad things. Children have beautiful complexions and they can wear most colours, but the best colours, and the ones I like designing for, are really colours of nature. For example, yellow daffodils, bluebells. It sounds very corny, but they're marvellous colours. And you can't reproduce those colours. You can't reproduce a daffodil colour or a bluebell colour, because they have a great translucency about them, which is very difficult. So the colours one selects are the ones which conjure the image of daffodils and bluebells. Designing, you might begin with a colour, or fabric, or a purpose. In playwear, you know that the fabric has got to be tough to stand up to all the wear of children. And so you might select a crimpline or a bri nylon, or something that would stand up to this wear. Or you might start with a fabric that's got a particular texture and design for that. You know how that particular fabric behaves, and that will influence your design. Or you might decide a particular look is developing which will follow on into children's wear. In the end, everything has to come together. Choice of colour, choice of fabric, something attractive and easy to care for, and something the child would like to wear.
Children were getting tired of the uniform that we used to have. It was expensive and it wasn't smart. It was old-fashioned. Our older children hated it and were beginning to reject it. And so was I. I wanted something that would give a lot of variety and yet be a school uniform. Gradually we came round to choosing crimpline slacks and jackets, a skirt and a pinafore dress in cherry red, a white dry nylon sweater and a nylon cherry spotted blouse.
Children have to be hardy creatures, as when they're at school they might spend 2 40-minute periods in the classroom and then go out in the playground for about 20 minutes. And they have to have clothes that are going to keep them cool inside or warm outside. I teach fashion at the College of Art, and when I talk about design with the students, I make sure that they realise that the garments have to be worn and they have to be comfortable. When one's designing, you don't put a dark dress that has a white collar and cuffs, because what you're virtually designing is a white dress, because the collar and cuffs are the things that get dirty. Once they're dirty, the whole dress has to be washed. There's an association in children's minds that they have to wear dark colours to school. They can wear bright colours at home. With bright nylon and crimpline, you can have dark colours, but they've got a luminosity about them, which make them nice to use. For example, the navy is marvellous, and if you team that with a burnt orange, which is a good colour to use with children, and it's more practical than yellow, you can use browns, creams, greens. All the shades really come out very well in these synthetic fabrics. Sleeves can be an important design feature for children. But you have to remember the size, that the fullness must be at the head of the sleeve and not at the wrist, because the child could move and knock pots over or knock pens over and make the kiddie feel clumsy, which is bad. Pockets, you must be able to put your handkerchief, all the bits inside them that you want. All the details, cuffs, collars, must be practical and must be comfortable for children, because children are moving all the time, they're not still. You hardly ever see a garment absolutely front on. Always movement, always in the round, which is partly the nice thing for children. I think the best school uniforms now are the ones which look at the uniform from the school's point of view. For example, they could pick a common colour or two common colours, one for the junior school, one for the senior school. But they can have a variety of shapes within them, which would suit the fat child and the thin child and the little one and the older one. But there would be a look for the school, which is what the school would want to achieve.
I well remember getting cross myself many times as a parent when I received letters from school saying, girls will wear, and that sort of thing. I don't think that's the way to get cooperation. We chose our uniform with the help of our home and school association. The parents were really interested. They had a hand in choosing it, and it was quite obvious from the beginning that they really liked it. It's certainly attractive and workmanlike, and the reaction of the children, too, has been very good. They're very fond of it. We now have something like 95% of our children wearing this uniform.
I think gym clothes are much better now, because we had to wear sort of bloomers, gym tunics. It was a complete sort of disaster. But now you can wear gym outfits, which are sort of stretchy tops and pants all in one, in fabrics like bright nylon. You can get bright colours. And because they're stretchy, then the children can move in them easily. And the bright colours make the children look good, and it's a big advantage if you've got 30 or 40 children. You could see what they're doing or what they shouldn't be doing all at the same time. There's less for occasions these days, which is much better. Children aren't little dolls to be dressed up. You don't dress up to go to school. You don't dress up to play. There's a blurred line between the two. So that school becomes much more fun. It's learning, but it's also something you enjoy rather than something you have to do. And I think the clothes reflect this. You have a much lighter, happier effect in the clothes. They're much more comfortable. And they can be clothes that you wear at home, not necessarily only for school. I think clothes are happier and the schools can be a much better place. I mean, who needs brown lisle stockings?